Some bomb explodes right then. It's a bomb. Duck and cover. That flash means act fast. Sundays, holidays, vacation time, we must be ready every day, all the time, to do the right thing if the atomic bomb explodes.
I think the important thing that people don't realise is that the nuclear issue does affect everyone. It affects us at a number of levels, but it's a moral question. The fact that there is that much potential power and destruction, and awesome destruction, which has been used on one occasion. All you have to do is see a photo of the victims of Hiroshima and you'll understand that it can never be allowed to happen again. And if everyone stands up and says, look, you know, we don't want this to happen, we think it's very, very wrong, and we're prepared to do something about it, then maybe we can change it. And if we don't get excited and yell and get agitated, then it won't happen. So that's basically what's got to happen, and it's got to happen now.
I guess change is a slow process. But sometimes you feel like speeding the process up, particularly when it's got to do with nuclear arms and the possibility of us all not being here tomorrow. Song called That Day Is Coming Sooner. Let's hope it gets here in a hurry.
Time to be your way. just want to be really succinct when we get out there so that the issues are really clear and people realise what our commitment is. Stopping all nuclear warfare, weapons, stopping Australia's involvement totally in the exporting of uranium, stopping American bases being in Australia and B-52s coming into Australia.
But really we're committed to telling the Australian youth about the problems because a lot of them are unaware, and this is why this concert's so important, because basically it's going to be a rock audience and we have the chance to get up there and tell them a few things and a few things to actually do to help the issue now.
Well, I think the concerts like this are very effective, and also there's not much else that the public can do. The public gets to vote and to get up and scream and shout whenever it can, which is, what this is all about.
Please put your hands together for Gary Foley. Also like you to welcome from the Tanami Desert, Chavanunga.
Hello! Me and my brother Bobby here, I represent the Aboriginal people here today. And if you want to know what our struggle's all about, then the words of this next song tell it beautifully. Don't ever be sucked in by the lies that people tell you. And the words of this song say, somebody lied when they told you what happened to us. Thank you.
Standing on Why we're here is because, like most other sensible, clear-thinking Australians and citizens of the world, you know, we have a vested interest in having a planet to live on. And unless you have sort of gatherings like this where a lot of people with the same feeling can get together and show the world, Melbourne, Australia or whatever, that there are enough people around who care, then we've lost the fight. So we're here and we've won, you know? I mean, look at all those people.
Oh, you look out your window in the cold gray dawn. It's 7 o'clock on a Monday morning. For a cup of coffee, better make it a strong one. When a man on the radio says it's gonna rain and it's gonna blow, it'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. Australia marched out of Vietnam, out in the streets against Uncle Sam, and we won the fight. It was a long one. Uranium demo the other day, one of my mates got dragged away. If they slammed the door, I heard her say, it'll be alright in the long run. Tan bloke who works with me, and we swabble laughs and company, and he slapped me on the back, said you're wrong, son. Isn't the land I was told it'd be, it's not so equal and not so free. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. Come on, it'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. From the shadow of history, a comic screen, the sheerest curse, people dream, pains and right turns, they've been the wrong one. Troop ships leave and the headlines blaze, Australia remembers happier days, faith lives on within the haze, it'll be all sit in your camp and you stare at the fire, but now struggle, where's the hope? It's higher and you sing to yourself, it'll be alright, be alright in the long run. And the sun gives ground to a long cold night, screw up your courage for another fight, but you know in your heart it'll be alright in the long run. Sunstreams in with power and might, and you look at your kids in a different light, and you know in your heart as you kiss them goodnight, it'll be alright in the long run. We'll tell Australia.
Hopefully gigs like this will roll on too. I mean, it won't just be single incidents, the whole thing will develop into some sort of mass movement, because it can't be done by small cliques of people, even though they might be very, very, very well-minded. No, it's just got to be done by a mass movement of people reminding politicians that this is the way the public feel.
This is a song about two mates of mine who went to Vietnam. They were killed there, but they're not dead yet. They're Agent Orange victims. The song's called A Walk in the Light Green, and for those of us who didn't go to Vietnam, it could have been us. Mum and Dad and Denny saw the passing out parade at Puckapunyal. It was a long march from cadets. The 6th Battalion was the next to turn. It was me who drew the card. We did Canungra, Shoalwater before we left. And in Townsville lined the footpaths as we marched down to the quay. This clipping from the paper shows us young and strong and clean. And there's me in me slouch hat with me SLR and greens. God help me. I was only 19. Buntow riding Chinooks to the dust of Nui Dat. I've been in and out of choppers now for months. And we made our tents at home, BB and pin-ups on the lockers, and an Asian orange sunset through the scrub. And can you tell me, Doctor, why I still can't get to sleep? And night time's just a jungle dark and a barking M16. And what's this rash that comes and goes? Can you tell me what it means? God help me. I was only 19. Four-week operation, when each step could mean your last one on two legs. It was a war within yourself, but you wouldn't let your mates down till they had you dusted off. So you closed your eyes and thought about something else. And then someone yelled out contact from the bloke behind me swore. We hooked in there for hours, then it got all muddy raw. Frankie kicked a mine the day that mankind kicked the moon. God help me. He was going home in June. I can still see Frankie drinking tinnies in the Grand Hotel on a 36-hour rec leave in Buntow. I can still see Frankie lying screaming in the jungle till the morphine came and killed the bloody row. And the Anzac legends didn't mention mud and blood and tears, and the stories that my father told me never seemed quite real. I caught some pieces in my back that I didn't even feel. God help me. I was only 19. Can you tell me, Doctor, why I still can't get to sleep? And why the Channel 7 chopper chills me to my feet? And what's this rash that comes and goes? Can you tell me what it means? God help me. I was only 19.
Quite true that Australia is not really as endangered as the Northern Hemisphere, as Europe especially, but there's no doubt that Australia would be a target if there were a full nuclear exchange between the United States and the Soviet Union, because we have critical American bases here, bases which monitor Soviet troop movements and which would send a message to the United States about those troop movements, which would give them the feeling that they ought to launch an attack. We also have satellites which relay information and communicate with submarines which would launch, American submarines which would launch ballistic missiles. So the Soviet Union thought they were going to be attacked. The first thing they'd do is drop a bomb on these American bases in Australia. And that would happen definitely at the start of an all-out war.
Why am I doing this? Because I like to be alive. I enjoy making people laugh and entertaining people. But I also like to be alive. I want to stay alive. And unfortunately, there's a number of nuclear decisions that the world is making. And more people are living in fear every day. And I don't want to live in fear, I want to enjoy myself, and I want to continue performing. And if I'm dead or ashes, or sort of like nothing, then I won't be able to do it anymore, because it's not very funny. You can only do it once.
Let's go black and white.
Thank you.
here if you want us to get out of here.
Okay. I believe that it's a weapon that's stronger than nuclear weapons, and that is you staying young in here.
Thank you. Sense, if there is a nuclear war, then the world will not be worth living in. So I mean, it's not like any other war or world war. It's almost hard to conceive. The reality of a war is means the end of this earth. And I think we should do something about that. I believe in mass action. I believe that people should search for information and make sure that they do know the truth. Sort of like it has been described as a balance of terror, and that's really how I see it. And so that's why it seems to me that a lot of people tend to rationalize the threat of a nuclear holocaust out of their minds and pretend that it's not real. The whole, as I said before, as the conception of it is so incredible, it's so terrifying that you just block it out. Well, I think we've got to deal with it before it happens, because I have faith in the human race.
My name's Colin. Nice of you to come down to this show. I won't take up much of your time. It's good of you to come to this thing so that they don't drop that thing. Is it the man come to take me away? Why do they follow me? It's not the future that I can see. It's just my fantasy. Knocking at my door. Go away. Look around here no more. Can't you see that it's late at night? Very tired. when I'm not feeling right. All I wish is to be alone. Stay away, don't you invade my home. Best off if you hang outside. Don't come in, I'll only run and hide. Who can it be now? 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 Who can it be knocking at my door? Make no sound, tiptoe across the floor. If he hears you knock out there, knock out there, I'll be trapped, and here I'll have to stay. I've done no harm, I keep to myself. There's nothing wrong with my state of mental health. I like it here with my childhood friend. Here they come. Who can it be now? Who can it be now? Who can it be now? Is it the man? Come to take me away. Why do they follow me? It's not the future that I can see. It's just my fantasy.
Seem to be in a very good-humoured mood at the moment, as well as a very receptive one. They're all excited about the event. They're all looking forward, of course, to see Midnight Oil later on tonight as well. There's no denying that. And I think everybody is here as one at the moment. Nobody's come here purely for the musical side of it. I think that's pretty apparent, and that's great.
In the window, I've seen faces in the street. They talk and walk of nothing. I know many restless summers. The sand dunes, I imagine, a place without a postcard. Now our people were so beautiful, straight and miles away.
Well,
9, 8, 7, 6, 5 at Central Central City Blue in the face. The world is only 12 hours away.
Short memory. The rising British India, partition of Arabia, the deadline in South Africa. Short memory. The story of El Salvador, the silence of Hiroshima, destruction of Cambodia. The sights of hotels by the Nile, the designated Hilton style, with running water specially bought, short memory. A smallish man, Afghanistan, a watchdog in a nervous land, they're only there to lend a hand, short memory.
Oh,
Midnight Oil are here today because we're concerned about the issue of nuclear disarmament. And I think when we were in Europe, we realised how close people there were becoming to understand that if the Americans or the Russians had decided they were actually going to set something off, you know, they were faced with the possibility that they may have nuclear warheads detonated in their backyard or in their laundry. And so we became aware of the nuclear thing, and when we got back here we started to think about it and get concerned about it. And people in Australia are unaware that a nuclear device has been detonated here at Maralinga in the early 50s, and they're unaware of the facilities that the Americans have put here, which are used in their defence network and in their attack network. And the oils, you know, we want to keep on making music and we want people to keep on enjoying it, and so consequently I think it's very important to come and play and to dance and to learn, and that's why we're here.
Tonight's Redwood. You as fast as can thine eye. We'll be right back.
Have a great old institution called volunteering. A sergeant comes out and says, I want three volunteers to clean out the lavatories. You, and you, you'll do. You've been volunteer whether you like it or not. Well, there's a lot of volunteering going on these days. A lot of us have been volunteered to stay away from work whether we want it or not. It's like the old army system. You, and you, you're all on the dole.
Volunteering people must get into your blood. It's the way people at the top operate. Now we've got 70-year-old men in Washington and Moscow saying we need a few hundred million volunteers to be ready to drop dead tomorrow or next week or next year. You, and you, you'll do. Australians are being lined up too. We've been volunteered already. We've got a nuclear submarine communications base at Northwest Cape. We've got stations at Pine Gap and Nurungar passing on satellite information they'll need for a nuclear first strike. We're letting B-52 bombers use Darwin, In just a little while, they'll be carrying the nuclear equivalent of 2 million tons of TNT each. You and I have been well and truly volunteered. If the bombs drop, there'll be a warhead or two thrown at Australia, and not just Darwin or Pine Gap either. With about 10,000 warheads in stock, the Russians will spare at least one or two for Sydney and Melbourne. I don't know exactly what I've been volunteered for. Am I supposed to die in the blast when a building collapses on me? Or turn into a pile of ash when the fireball scoops me up? Or maybe I've got one of the roles that are supposed to be better, where my skin gets roasted away with third-degree burns, or I get a dose of radiation and death comes more slowly and painfully. Well, none of that sounds like a good role for me. I've got things I want to do, and they don't fit in with what they volunteered me for, whatever it is. I don't even fancy being alive after a war like that, with the country wrecked and 90% of the people I know dead, wandering around with a Geiger counter trying to find a safe piece of ground to dig a hole in. Well, I've decided they're the ones that can go to hell. I'm staying here alive. And whatever role they've got lined up for my kids, they can keep that too. My children are going to live and grow up in a world that's worth living in, not the graveyard they'll have after they've won their nuclear war. As an actor, usually, if you don't want a role, you say, let someone else do it. But I'm not saying that. I'm saying, let nobody else do it. If the people who are running things want people to play corpses, let them take the role themselves, but leave all of us out of it. They could still do it without me, but they can't do it without me and without you and without all the others in Australia and in Germany and in Russia and in America and in Romania and in just about every country that's involved in this dirty business. And people in all these countries are jacking up. They're saying, don't volunteer us for the part. We don't want to play it. And when enough of us have said this and got out on the streets and at the politicians, then we can be really sure that this deadly scenario they're cooking up will never happen. We're writing a different story. One where people don't get volunteered for dirty jobs like standing in line for the dole or lying on the street as a corpse. And it's looking pretty good so far. Even where it's a lot harder to buck the system, in America or even in Russia, people are on the move all over the world. The bombs are not going to wipe out people. It's people, it's us, that are going to wipe out the bombs.